Great day, everybody. Welcome to your energy report for the week. We also had a new moon solar eclipse, but I'm gonna do a separate reading on that because the effects of that are gonna be pretty extensive and go well into 6 months, even a year, right? But I did wanna get into the energy of the week. The first card coming up is expand time. All right, expand time. So for me, what I felt in that moment, I was like, well, how do we expand time? And I was thinking by being really present, right? We expand time by being really present. And I feel that there's lots of guilt coming up around being present, around just sitting in the moment and sitting in what is. And that actually makes me think about something that People's Oracle, I just shared Dana's post on my story, so go look at it. She was saying that yes, intention and desire are really important tools for right now, but also a need for sobriety and resourcefulness to say to ourselves, if nothing changed right now, would we be okay in that moment, right? So the guilt that's coming up is definitely related to work and the efforts that we're putting in. I know a lot of people are like, well, I should have been able to produce more in 2020. And just needing to release judgment, needing to release any judgments that you have about yourself, that in fact, the call wasn't to do more work. It was just to be present, like I said, to expand time, right? And say, what's actually accessible and available to me right now? Maybe I'm not meant to be doing X, Y, and Z. I'm actually meant to be doing, you know? So there was a sort of conflict I'm feeling, and you guys are still conflicted in that in this moment. And so releasing any guilt about what you did or did not produce this year. And then reset again has been coming up literally for weeks. So December, reset. And I love this. The call is to dive into something new with the Fool card coming up, right? And so this sort of, like I said, releasing this guilt about what needs to happen, and instead being like, well, what do I feel called to right now? And what can I, like People's Oracle said, what is available to me right now? Who can I cling to? What can I cling to? What energies and tools are available to me right now without me doing much of anything, right? Sister Shaman always says, look 6 feet in front of you and what you need is probably right there, right? Even the people that you have in your phone, like they're there, they're accessible to you. And I'm feeling that the reason that you guys have so much guilt also is because you guys are very much worried about perceptions of you. You're worried about what people are saying about you. And honestly, everyone's thinking about themselves. So actually you're thinking more about you than they are, right? This year has made us all quite, called us to be way more internal, right? With the lockdowns and all these things. So actually people are thinking about themselves more than they're thinking about you, okay? And Spirit is saying that we need to do this to reset these sort of perceptions, release this guilt and shame about the work that we're doing, because we're being called to elevate. We're being called to elevate because the impasse, now this card came up, you guys, this card came up a couple weeks ago in another reading, and it was upright, right? We said that you're at an impasse for a reason. The doors are about to open, okay? So you guys need to stop thinking about what other people are saying about you and focus on yourself. You guys are so worried. Nine of Swords coming up. You guys are so worried about what other people are saying. Whole time, you need to rest and rejuvenate, like I said, in the December collective reading. Rest and rejuvenate so that you can really get your coin up, so you can really get to the producing what's right in front of you, right? The King of Pentacles is very resourceful, right? To Dana's point, People's Oracle's point, right? He uses what's available to him now. He multiplies. So he's not really worried about, oh, well, it looks like I only have this much. It doesn't matter what it looks like. It matters what I can do with it. It matters who the people I can call to support, right? So be really present, all right? I'm gonna summarize it for y'all. So being really present is super, super important, and releasing any guilt about what you are doing, right? There is no should. That's a judgment that you've put onto yourself, what you should be doing, right? And the call is to dive into the projects, into, you know, whatever feeling you're feeling, right? Maybe it's on projects that you're wanting to do. Maybe it's certain dynamics that you're wanting to create. Maybe it's you wanting to be different, right? So dive into that. Release any worries. Release any self-perceptions. Like, you guys need to forgive yourself. And by forgiving yourself, you forgive all others so that you can now have these new visions about what it looks like to create, to be, to love, to be in relationship with people, right? So releasing guilt and ushering in forgiveness so that you can elevate, because this impasse that we were at in the beginning of the month, it's about the doors are about to open, right? The gates are about to be unlocked, and you over here crying, and I need you to pick your head up. All right, so you can see the opportunities that are around you, so that you see the resources and people around you, and to release the perception of gossip. All right, people aren't talking about you as much as you think. That's you, okay? That is most certainly you. I'm gonna pull one more card for us. Spirit, anything that we can use to ground ourselves. Adventure, yes, with this Fool card here, I love that. The call to adventure with the orca whale says, dare to do things differently. Oof. Sing your wild song, manifest your travel dreams, attempt the great journey with confidence. Be loyal. Friends and family are your treasures, right? Like I said, what's available to you now? Who can you lean into now? Who can you call for support now? Be brave. You are more powerful than you know, right? And this is the importance of mastering our minds, right? Because we're more powerful than we know. And so you are, you're trapped if you think you're trapped, right? You are in, you don't have enough if you think you don't have enough, right? There's just, and I don't mean to spiritually bypass, like there's obviously a lack of resources. That is true, right? There is a lack of resources for sure. But there's also, there are also people who are thriving, right? There are also people who have found a way. And so lean into that and lean into those people. And more than anything, lean into yourself, right? Get back into yourself. Find some peace. That is why I meditate. And yes, there is a call for adventure. Like I said, the doors are about to open, y'all. The doors are about to open. Dare to do things differently. All right, that's it. I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.